Good morning, everybody. You are watching the breakout of the Q&A session. This is one of the specific questions that was asked. So if you're looking for the answer to just that question, you can watch just this video. If, on the other hand, you want to watch the entire Q&A session, which has a lot more feedback from the live audience, just click here and you can watch that entire video. NickpedFilm says, first of all, he's two parts. He says, why is exposure unresponsive until the 6K photo mode is recording? Makes it hard to set the exposure. And then says, aha, found it. The constant preview was somehow set to off. And I responded, yes, that is super important feature to understand. And hence, that is why it is on here. So I can discuss constant preview, what it is, when to turn it on, when to turn it off, and how to do that. So let's start with the how. Let's do that to start with. So go into, let's go here, and go into the custom with the C and go into monitor display and scroll down to constant preview. There it is, constant preview on or off. All right, here's what this is. If you have constant preview set to on, whatever exposure changes you make to the camera, dialing the shutter speed up or down, whatever, will make the image look brighter or darker through the viewfinder. If you are in manual mode and you're doing that, you see the image change. If you are if you're in auto mode, aperture priority, and you take the exposure compensation dial, put it up or down, you'll see a change. Although that might override it and show you that anyway. This is mostly shows up in manual mode. And you think, well, that's great. That's what I want, right? This is one of the beautiful advantages of shooting mirrorless. I can see the image that I'm going to get before I push the button. There's no more guessing on exposure. If I'm looking at the image and I want it to be a little bit brighter, a little bit darker, I can adjust my aperture, shutter speed, ISO, exposure compensation, whatever, to get the look that I want, and then push the button and I get exactly what I saw. So why would I ever want to turn that off? There's a very good reason. I'm glad you asked. You want to turn that off if you're shooting with strobes. So here's what happens. So if you're shooting with a strobe, then your shutter speed is probably 1/25th, 250th of a second, whatever it might be, at, you know, aperture 5.6, at ISO 400, but you're shooting indoors. And so the camera thinks that the image is going to be super dark because it says, it's not enough light until the flash fires and it goes, oh, okay, that was enough light, and it exposes properly. The problem is if you're in constant preview, if you have it turned on and you set your camera to manual, you set the exposure the way you need it for the flash, you can't see anything through the viewfinder. So let me show you how this actually, what this looks like. Yeah, there we go. So I'm gonna set this constant preview to on. Let's start with on. And let's put the camera into manual mode. And I'm gonna set my ISO, it's manual, so everything's manual. And as I adjust my shutter speed, right, you can see the exposure changing, right? Or I change the aperture, you see it changing as well. Okay, so that's what you'd expect, right? That's what I want. Ooh, I want this dark, moody picture. That's how I'm gonna do it. So boom, I take the picture and away we go. But now you're gonna shoot strobe. So you're, okay, well, I need my speed list. Well, I want it at 200th, and I want this kind of stop down. I want big depth of field. I'm shooting a group. So F8, 200th of a second. Actually, let's go even farther. Let's make it like F13, there we go. And I'm going, I can't see anything. And then I push the button to autofocus and I go, oh, wait, what happened? Hold on. Oh, it's gone. But why? And this has come up, I've heard this so many times. The camera, the shot is totally dark until I push the shutter halfway and then it lights up for a second and then it goes away. I can't compose my shot. Again, because constant preview is set to on. The exposure in this environment, this setting, forget about the flash for a second, in this setting, the exposure of a 200th of a second at F13 is super dark, just like you see here. So that is no good if I'm shooting with strobe and shooting in the studio. So I need to go into my custom setting here, monitor displays, constant preview, and turn that off. And in fact, I have this, because I use this all the time, whenever I'm shooting in the studio, I'm constantly turning it on or off. I have this set into one of my custom personal settings here. So I have this in here as one of my constant personal settings, which is where to go, constant preview, there it is. Constant preview on or off, because I know I'm gonna wanna access this often. So let's turn this off. And now that same exposure, even though it's 200th of a second, F13 is clearly way underexposed. If I take the picture right now without a strobe and I hit play, we're going to see a very dark image, right? That's what the image looks like, so that's no good. But if the strobe fired, then of course it would illuminate properly. So that is why you need it. So now you see as I make changes to the shutter speed, the image is not changing on the scene in front of me. So super, super important thing to understand. Usually you're gonna leave it on, but there are clearly times when you need to turn that off. And that is constant preview, how it works, and why to use it.